Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to do chicken salad sandwich. I'm still working on sandwiches for you because of requests. If you get tired of sandwiches, let me know. We'll go on to something else. I did sneak a couple of things in there over the weekend that were just things I wanted to do. But I do try to fill your requests, and if you want sandwiches or casseroles, which have been requested a lot, then I try to get to them when I can. The chicken salad, I'm going to start with some nice canned chicken. And it doesn't really matter what brand you have. This happened to be Valley Fresh. And this is a 10-ounce can. I have drained it and I've saved the juice here, the chicken broth. If I should want to make my mix thinner, I might want to add some of that. But we'll see how it turns out. So I have the 10-ounce can. And I wanted to show you that it generally comes in a smaller can as well. And this probably works out for my proportions a little better. Anyway, this is a 5-ounce can, same brand. And this is 98% fat-free. So it's really kind of a healthy choice to make for a dish. And likewise, this is 98% fat-free. So I'm going to just set my chicken broth aside and move down a little bit where I have some ingredients. I have 1/2 cup of finely chopped celery. So you need to make that fairly fine or it would be kind of hard to consume in a sandwich. And then we have grapes. And actually, I'll tell you, there are many ways you can make chicken salad. You can put pineapple in it. You could put just about anything that you like, green peppers or olives or whatever. The flavors need to blend well. And this is sort of an imitation of a chicken salad that's served at one of the restaurants in Lexington that is a very popular dish. So I'm going to try to make it the way they do it. And they put grapes in it. So these are red seedless grapes, and I have cut them in half. They don't do that, but I think it's better for the sandwich to have them in halves. 1/2 cup of that. Then we have, these are fancy pecan pieces or chopped pecans. Those you can put in like they are if you want to, but I think it would be better if you put them in a kitchen chopper and get them very fine. Again, just because it's a sandwich and you don't want to chew down on a big piece of nut. So I will put 1/4 cup of very finely chopped pecans. If you don't have the means of making these very finely chopped, I wouldn't try a knife or anything, it would take you forever. I would just go ahead and put the chopped pecans in as they came. All right, now I need to bind these together. So I have 1/2 cup of mayonnaise. And I've chosen the free mayo, which cuts down a little bit on the fat and calories. So that's kind of one thing about this dish. It has some good vegetables and fruits, the celery and the grapes, as well as some nuts, and then that good lean chicken. And if we don't put some really fatty mayonnaise in there, then we're doing pretty well. So I'm choosing the free mayo. Now I want to stir this around a little bit. I might need that fork to chunk up some of the chicken because I noticed there were some very large pieces. If this doesn't get it, then we'll use the fork and just separate those a little bit more. Now I have this all stirred and you can see that it's pretty thick. But I am choosing not to add any of that broth and not to go back to the mayonnaise jar and add any of that because the worst thing you can have is a soggy sandwich. And also I want you to be able to use this as chicken salad as well as a chicken salad sandwich. And I think it's just right. So what we're going to do is make our sandwich first. You'll notice that in restaurants, a lot of times croissants are used for chicken salad. Now that brings in a lot of fat, so that's your choice. If you want to just use whole wheat bread, that would make it much healthier. But just to be a little different, because I use whole wheat bread a lot in my sandwiches, and I've used every kind of bread I can think of to show you just something a little different, what I did was to take one of these, and you know I'm really big on sealing it off. So I did toast it on my cooktop, and that introduced a little bit of butter. If you want them toasted but you don't want the butter, then you can stick them under a broiler for just a few seconds. Well, maybe 10, 15 seconds, but I didn't want to heat up the kitchen by turning on the broiler, so that's the reasoning here. So I'm just going to get some of this out. I think maybe a smaller spoon would be easier for me to apply this, and we'll make our sandwich. Look how good that looks. It's nice and colorful, and you know it's going to be tasty. The chicken was nice and fresh in those cans. It's so easy to do. It's a tremendously easy sandwich, and it looks kind of fancy. You put the top on, and actually, I meant to put my lettuce on the bottom, but the lettuce is going to go on the top this time. So we'll just put it right there, and then put the top on, and think of that in reverse, because I really would have put that on the bottom. And I have some extra lettuce that I'm just going to remove. And then we have a nice little plate here where we have our chicken salad sandwich. And then I decided, since it was based with some red grapes, I would use a little decor that was red grapes and some bananas for that lunch. Makes a really nice lunch. You can still cut on the calories a little bit if you want to. Now, another way of serving this is just as chicken salad. So I made a plate of what you might see at a restaurant. You might see something like this to the side, and then a whole croissant. And a lot of times you'll see a little bit of butter that is drizzled over the croissant. Again, I'm adding fat here, but I'm knowledgeable about it, and I'm just showing you options. I'm not saying you need to do that, because I'm really into fitness and wellness, and I myself try to avoid fats, but you know, a lot of people eat a lot more fat than this in their diet. So for a chicken salad, just pick up one on your plate and put out a nice little amount. And then this individual has a little bit of salad here on the side, and then their main course, the chicken salad, and to go with it, a nice warm croissant.